We just want to try to get to a point where we are as self-sufficient as we possibly can be. Two lithium-ion batteries.
CTEK.
Victron. This is scary.
I hate electrics, but it's growing on me. I thoroughly enjoyed this project.
Hi everybody, and welcome to GrizzlyNbear Overland. This week it's a special episode on a major upgrade to our off-grid solar system. A huge thank you to all our amazing patrons. Back in June we started planning a solar upgrade. At the time we thought we were on our way to Australia, so we contacted Einar at Klarman Automotive Solutions in Perth, Western Australia.
Hello, Einar, it's Lee here. How you doing, mate? Awesome. We've been very lucky to have been offered a solar and electrical upgrade from the company that builds our camper, four-wheel campers. We're super pumped about that. We live in our camper. We have lived in it for 3 years. Ideally, I'd like to be able to camp up somewhere and last at least, 5 days to 7 days. In the cooler weather, it was actually okay, but that's the only reason is because the fridge is not really running. We were driving a lot too. Our alternator is charging our batteries when we drive. And at the moment, we're lucky to get through a day, especially in the warmer weather, you know? Okay, so we've got the fridge, a drone, and Canon SLR camera. Two laptops which are getting charged regularly. Laptops are draining a lot of electricity. We don't have an inverter. Okay, we've got a diesel heater, 12 volt fan, a roof vent. LED lights don't take much, do they? Yep. All right, perfect, awesome. And as far as batteries, I've done a lot of research and I'd sort of convinced myself now that lithium is the way to go. Would you agree with that? Awesome. We plan to be full-time in our camper for at least the next probably 5 to 10 years.
Perfect.
We will keep in touch and hopefully we can get everything in and sorted and no dramas with customs, and we're really looking forward to it. Thank you, Heiner. Bye-bye.
The plan fell through as we couldn't go to Australia. We stayed in Japan and decided to go ahead with the upgrade over here.
We didn't have sun for weeks during the wet season. The temperature were pretty high. Our AGM batteries are totally dead.
Permanently damaged.
We need an upgrade.
We're super excited to be back at our friend's GAC in Hokkaido and work together on this big project.
This is our current setup, which we've had since we bought this camper. Two Victron 60 amp hour gel AGM batteries.
Officially dead.
We've discharged them way too much for AGM batteries. We've got a 75/15 Victron Blue Solar MPPT charger. We've got a battery separator, which works on our dual battery system in the Defender. It's a smart system where it charges the batteries when we're driving. After it's topped up the auxiliary battery in the Defender, this solenoid opens and allows it to charge then the dual battery system in the camper. Battery separator is no good for lithium, which I found out during my research. I'm useless with electrics. But I have been watching a lot of YouTube videos and reading quite a lot over the last couple of weeks, trying to get my head around it a little bit. There's a lot of options out there, where in Japan we had to use what was available without waiting a long time for shipping coming from overseas and paying heavy import customs taxes. Oh, and we've got a shunt here as well. At the back there, all the stuff plugged in is the Bluetooth dongle. That just measures your amperage and the BMS plugs into it.
What's the MPPT?
The MPPT is Managed Power Point something. Maximum Power Point Tracking. No idea what that means, but that's what it stands for. Protects from overcharging. Controls the rate that it charges at. It controls over discharge. It controls the max voltage. We're going to stick with Victron because that's been a really reliable system. Then we can reuse our Victron battery monitor here. The BMS battery management system is compatible with the new lithium batteries. I'll just have to change some settings, which I can do on my phone. That's quite technical stuff. I've watched some videos on that too.
Hey!
Okay.
Jurosama. Oh, good to see you.
Ah. Oh my god. I didn't think we'd be seeing you again so soon.
I thought so.
You thought so? You knew.
Yeah, I knew you already.
Gak started by preparing labels for every single wire. This man is so organized.
The new Grizzly wiring diagram. Yeah. Extra two solar panels, two lithium ion. It's almost like a power plant off grid.
Oh my god.
Let's talk about our new system, shall we? Starting with the batteries. We have 2 ampere time lithium iron batteries of 100 amp hours each. The main reasons for choosing lithium was the performance and the weight. About 11 kilograms each.
My finger hurts.
Absorbed glass mat battery would be 30 kilos roughly, so it's a third of the weight. Should be a straight swap out, just about. This is what you do on all the electrical connections.
Should use the heat gun, but
I don't know, it's fine. The cool thing about LiFePO or lithium batteries is we can put them like that. They can be mounted anyway, so I'm gonna have them both on their side on top of each other like that. I know what corrugation does, you know, if the two batteries are rubbing against each other like that, that can cause some damage maybe to the outside of them on bad roads. So I'll put maybe 3 or 4 millimeter square of rubber just to cushion one battery on top of the other.
Super power.
Very nice.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 1 millimeter. Well, it doesn't matter. Yeah. You're connecting 2 batteries together. Parallel connection. You get same voltage and a different amount of capacity depending on how much you have.
Don't tell Gak that I'm cutting the rubber with scissors. No one's ever gonna see this piece of rubber.
Show me.
Unless Gak wants to take the batteries out when he arrives, then we're in trouble. Having lithium-ion batteries shipped from outside of Japan would have cost us an absolute fortune. So we've made do with what's available with as much research as we possibly could have done. As you can see down there, maybe I've got the aluminium angle, which will stop the batteries moving that way. I've got another piece you can't see in there. And then these straps will hold it nice and snug in place. Look at that for a fit. Sometimes you get lucky. I thought that buckle there was gonna hit. 9:15 PM, obviously. We're having coffee and we're gonna finish work. And last night we worked to midnight. Special coffee.
Next, let's move on to the solar panels. Because it works really well, we are keeping our current 165 watt solar panel. We will add 2 extra panels, eco-worthy, monocrystalline of 180 watt each.
That looks good.
Looks like heavy.
Perfect.
Perfect.
All that research paid off, I guess. Yeah. I've been trusted, but I'm not actually sure if I'm trusted, but asked what would you like me to do? He's given me the job to cut the aluminium, which I'm more than capable of, I hope. I said to Gak, I said, it's okay, even if I cut it a little bit not straight, it's on the roof, nobody's ever gonna see it. And then we joked and we said, but Gak will know and he's never gonna be able to sleep again. Gak wouldn't allow me to cut the angle with normal gloves. He had some special gloves. I didn't even know they made special discs for aluminium.
Yep. Oh, cool. Yeah, I'm pretty satisfied with the line.
We're going to get a lot of comments on this video, I'm sure, asking why we didn't go with the little thin flexi panels. I considered it, but we've had a very bad experience. We killed one already in Morocco at the beginning of our trip. That's why I chose not to. We're going with the rigid framed panels because I truly believe that they're a lot stronger. I know it's a little bit heavier. We'll see how difficult it is to lift, but we'll probably need to upgrade our gas struts at some stage to assist.
Good job, man.
Special solar cable. So there was a screw hole already there, which is actually penetrates all the way through. We're trying to think of a way to penetrate these wires through inside to the camper.
I'm not sure about two cables.
Without it looking too messy. We're severely limited as the way we can do it.
Can you push the cable?
Back to you?
Yeah.
I went through all right anyway. This is scary.
They're tight. Ooh. Still really tight, huh?
Yeah.
I'll take you inside
a bit little... easier.
Going better?
No, really.
Gak, what on?
You're just a millimeter.
Gak on the outside, and he is feeding the wire through to me. We can see your shadow through there. That's Gak. That's Gak right there.
You can recharge from here.
What?
Yeah. It's really handy. The connector for solar panel. MC4 connectors. We have a diode here. One direction only to MPPT solar charger. And we also have a fuse just in case. We don't want to get any damage on the solar panel. Because this is an Overland vehicle. This is waterproof. And soundproof.
So that's the three panels installed, and we're about to see if we can lift the roof with all this extra weight. Oh, that's heavy. Shit. Definitely gonna need new pistons.
I'm dreaming of you like wiring connect and solar panels and so many, and you like, which is good, yeah.
Controller has a max of 200 watts, no good anymore. And look at the size. You can see the size difference between them there. Bluetooth compatible with the new MPPT controller.
The two new solar panels will be connected in parallel to this MPPT. The CTEK works as a lithium DC to DC battery charger from the vehicle alternator.
So this is our CTEK D250SE. I don't know much about these things, I'm still learning. That's one hell of a big user's manual.
Because our solar panels are mismatched, our previous panel has its own separate system connected to the CTEK.
When that battery is full, when the car is off, it sends a trickle charge through to the defender, to the vehicle battery, just tops up the battery.
Which is cool.
Which is really cool. Connector coming from the camper batteries that plugs into the socket at the back of the defender, coming from the dual battery system in the defender. We're just tracing wires. This positive will now go to this new CTEK. This green one, just a pa. Judgment day, solar installation is complete. I was so nervous last night at 3 a.m. to connect that final battery. Camper installed back on the defender. We've done our next big test that I was holding my breath for. Plug in the camper to the defender. We ran the engine and it is sweet. So super happy.
The panels are working very well. In a hot day with cloud cover, our batteries return from 80 to 100% in less than 2 hours.
We're so stoked, we're extremely happy. I just wish we'd done this years ago. Struggling with solar for the last 2 years and finally we've committed and gone for it.
Thank you so much, Gak, for your help, your knowledge and your time. You are an absolute legend.
We'd just like to say a massive thank you to 4-Wheel Campers, especially Dan and Aaron for all the help and generosity during this project. I have to throw a big thank you to Jake at Rambling Roots on Instagram because he was sort of my inspiration for this entire job. Well, my inspiration definitely to try and do this myself with the assistance of Mr. Gack. That gave me even more confidence, obviously.
Next week, we'll be still at Gack's and we will be working on the car. We hope to see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.
I have to use this every day to vacuum the house under Steffi's orders and instructions.